Hi guys, it's a free day. I will show you guys the top 3 best decks right now in Clash Royale. So, after the new balance changes, we're going to see a huge shift on the meta in Clash Royale. So, let me show you guys the top 3 best decks on the new meta in Clash Royale right now. So, the first deck is this Mega Knight Beatdown deck. So, Royal Hawk, Snowball, Poison, and Hunter get buffed. And not only that, with this deck, you also have the Mega Knight and Prince combo with Fisherman Hunter combo. So basically, the defenses are rock solid. The second deck right here is P.E.K.K.A. Bridge Spam. So with the buff Poison, this deck is unstoppable. And with also the buff Snowball. Now with the Snowball, you can completely kill a Goblin Barrel with zero issues. And therefore, against bait decks, this deck stands 100% wins. So, our last deck right here is Lava Loon. With the new guards and tombstone, defending is much easier with this deck. So anyways, before we go into some matches, hit the subscribe button down below and also leave a like. So anyways, let's go into some matches to dominate people with these new meta decks, starting off with our first deck right here. Now with our first match right here with our Mega Knight Beatdown deck with Royal Hawks. So with this deck, you wanna play really passively because, okay, never mind, this guy rush, so I need to defend that. So basically what I wanna say is, you wanna play this deck really passively because you wanna get a massive elixir lead. And if you get the elixir lead, you can rush immediately with Royal Hawks on the opposite lane because the Royal Hawks deal a lot of damage right now. Now, this guy with Bandit and Barbarian Barrel looks like some sort of bridge spam. Okay, I'm right. Now we can go Mega Knight right here. The Mega Knight will wreck the Ram Rider. And according to my nerd analytics, he will be low on elixir. Okay, he will do Infro Dragon, but luckily for me, I've Zapis. So that Inferno will not work. Now that Inferno got wrecked, he wasted so much elixir. Now we can go Royal Hawks right here. The Royal Hawks will wreck his tower. See guys, the Royal Hawks give so much damage. And he has nothing from Mega Knight and my Royal Hawks because he's down too much elixir. Now we can do Prince on the bridge right here because he's low so much elixir. I know that because I'm counting his elixir. See guys, I know it. He even gave up. So yeah. This is a GG right here. This man stands 0 chance for our deck. Now, okay, never mind. This guy hand not gave up. But still, his right tower and left tower already dead. Let's see, can this man come back, okay? Now, we can do probably, okay, definitely. Mega Knight right here. But sadly for me, I missed the Ram Rider because I'm a dumb, okay? But luckily, our Mega Knight can shred his Mega Knight. Boom. Okay, you will do Inferno right there. But sadly, then would work because I have Zapis, of course. Because I'm a pro, okay? Now, Mega Knight will jump if you not respond for it. Okay, never mind. I'm a huge liar. Now, we can go Hawks right here. Follow up with a Prince. You will not have Mega Knight on hand, so you will be dead. And my Prince will strike your Electro Wizard and your freaking Ram Rider. Now I can do Fisherman right here. Boom. With Fisherman Hunter combo OP. Now we can do Zapis right here to kill the Inferno Dragon. Boom. Let's go guys. We're amazing. I know. Now he will most likely Mega Knight to Zapis. Yep, I'm right. Now I guess I can do Royal Hawks right here on this thing. Okay, never mind. The Mega Knight got anger. That's really bad. Because now he has a massive push. Now I can do a Mega Knight right here. Okay. Wow. The Mega Knight just walked on the opposite lane. Sure, the Mega Knight is stupid, right? Now, Fisherman. Okay, now I can do Prince right here. With Zapis. Boom. Get wrecked. Haha. Look at our defense. Are rock solid. So now we can proceed to our second deck of the video right here. Okay guys, second match right here. Facing against this man. Now, we can do Bandit on the back maybe because with this deck, you wanna be really aggressively and spamming consistently. Now, he will have Sparky, which is really good for us because I have P.E.K.K.A. and Electro Wizard to wreck that. So, he will have probably a Goblin Giant Sparky deck because that's what people use most likely. Okay then, you have a Mega Knight, surprise, surprise. Now I can do P.E.K.K.A. right here. The P.E.K.K.A. please wreck the Sparky. Okay, let's go. Now, sadly for me, I missed the Electro Wizard. But don't worry, I can snowball the Minion Horde and his hopes and dreams. absolutely got tracked. He don't even deal a single damage, and my Batarang and my Bandit shred his right tower completely, and also chip his king tower. So that's a massive win for my box right there. Now, most likely he will either give up or do Sparky. Okay, never mind. I not expect a Ram Rider. Now we can do this with this. Boom. Okay, your Ram Rider absolutely got wrecked and get absolutely zero value. So you can do that. I can poison a skeleton army. Boom. Now my Royal Ghost will connect. Let's do Barbarians. But now I can do Magic Archer right here to absolutely shred the Barbarians. Get wrecked. What Barbarians? More like free elixir, right? Now he will most likely go Mega Knight for my Magic Archer. Am I right? Okay, I'm absolutely right. Now we can go P.E.K.K.A. right here. So, according to my prediction, he will go Sparky on the back on the left lane for my P.E.K.K.A. And because of that, I can do Electro Wizard right here. Okay, never mind. He will do Minion Horde. Okay then, I guess I can snowball that, so it's even better, right? Now I can snowball right here. There's a massive positive elixir trade for my box. And now I can go Royal Ghost in the pocket to chip his tower away. He can only go Sparky. Okay, he will do that, but that will do damage to the tower. Now I can do Bandit right here with Magic Archer to shred the skeleton army. That's perfection, I know. Now he'll go Sparky on the back. I can do better than right here. Okay, I'm right. This time I will right, like the last time. Now he will go Magnet on front of the thing. Now I can do Electro Wizard right here. Boom. Okay, now I can go Royal Ghost. Okay, there's your fat Mega Knight. Let's go. Now we can go P.E.K.K.A. right here for the freaking thing. And now I can snowball the Minion Horde. Boom. I can do this. Okay, I probably should have poisoned that, but it's too late. Okay, now I can Electro Wizard all of this. Absolutely got wrecked. Total domination. Wow, this man even have mirror. Okay then, but it's worthless. So now let's go and dominate people right now with our last deck of the video. Okay, okay guys, now we're with our last deck of the video, which is Lavaloon. So with this deck, you wanna play really aggressively with Lavaloon first play consistently. You can do Lavaloon first play whenever you want to. It is fine, trust me. Now you have Mega Knight. Seems like you have either Graveyard or Royal Hawks because of the new meta. That's the only thing that you can have with the Mega Knight. Now, okay, this man also have Inferno Dragon. Well, thanks, because I get Snowball Berry from that. Now I can arrow the bats, boom, you get zero value. Now I can do minions right here for the Inferno Dragon. Boom, the Inferno Dragon will get killed, and now I have Lava Pups and minions. So now, I know what his deck is. He will have Miner with Skeleton Barrel, but luckily for me, I have Tombstone, so his Skeleton Barrel will not ever break through. Now, we can do Lava on the back right here, once our Elixir is 10. Okay, let's do it now, I don't even care. Boom, Lava Hound on the back. Now most likely he will go Skeleton Barrel. Okay, I'm right. Now we can go Tombstone right here. Boom. Okay, that absolutely got tracked, I know. Okay, I can do guards right here to tank the skeletons, because that can actually do a serious amount of damage. Now I can snowball the Inferno, boom, because that Inferno though. I can do minions right here probably for the Inferno. Okay, guards surprisingly deal a decent amount of damage. Okay, now his Inferno Dragon absolutely got tracked. Minions deal decent damage. Okay, now we can go Lava on the back again to repeat that interaction, because that interaction is 100% good. Okay, let's do this again. Lava Hound on the back right here. Boom. Hound on the back. Okay, he will have Skeleton Barrel on the back. Okay then, I guess. Oh, you wanna play that rush game. Okay, I can do guards right here. Boom. Okay, you wanna play that rush game, but luckily, okay, never mind. I just wanna say that he is Mega Knight will probably jump, but it actually jumped. Okay, now, oh, you wanna play that game? Sure. I probably snowball the Spirit Goblins because it is probably the most value for snowball. Now I can do Tombstone right here for the Skeleton Barrel, of course. Guard for the Miner, boom. Okay, this is actually way harder than I thought. But now we can do Lava on the back again. He will go Mega Knight on the bridge probably. Okay, I'm right. Now we can do this with this. Okay then, it's tower trading time because I've no choice, right? Yep, I've absolutely zero choice. Okay, never mind. I will be dead. But if you can play this deck, you can master it perfectly. But I'm not a Lavaloon player, so I cannot play Lavahun properly. Sorry for that. But anyways, thanks for watching. Remember to like and subscribe. Anyways, bye.